मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, मूविंग टू द न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस। ओके, नाउ आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस यू हैव हर्ड अबाउट दिस टर्म मेनी टाइम्स। ओके, नाउ दिस आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस वेयर द कंप्यूटर थिंक ऑन इट्स ओन। अर्लियर व्हाट हैपेंड, द कंप्यूटर आर टेकिंग द इंस्ट्रक्शन एंड देन दे आर बेस्ड ऑन दैट इंस्ट्रक्शन दे आर डूइंग द वर्क। But today's world, the computer are much smarter. Smarter in the sense they can think, they can process the data on their own, and they give us the output. If you have seen the Iron Man movie, you have seen there is a character named as Jarvis. Okay, now this character is acting like a artificial intelligence who is helping the Iron Man with various tasks. Okay, he is controlling the whole company and many things. Now, till now we have been learning that a computer is a machine which cannot work on its own. It takes our command and instruction and perform the task accordingly. What if the computer start thinking and doing the work itself, which I have just said? Now the computer in this process is thinking on its own. It is taking the its own decisions. Imagine a car without a driver that you have seen. Google has already started that service, the driverless car. Okay, that drop you to the school, say you goodbye, come back in the afternoon to pick you up from the school. Wouldn't that be great? All this is possible by the technology called artificial intelligence, and this is only possible through the artificial. Now the driverless car has been launched by the Google, then Tesla. Okay, where there is no need of the driver, the Google has created a driverless car where actually no driver is required. Okay, it will run on its own. Whereas Tesla can be run manually or through the driverless. In this chapter, we will study about how the artificial intelligence start and how it will change the world. Artificial intelligence is a way of making a computer, a robot, or a software think intelligently in a similar manner as human think. It is a simulation of human intelligence processed by the machine, especially the computer system. Now, artificially intelligent, what it say, it's a computer, robot, or the software that think intelligently. Okay, it will think like a human. Now in this simulation of human intelligence, it has been processed by the machines, especially the computer system. It include the, what are the thing it is doing? First of all, it is doing the learning. It will reason with you. It will ask you why it is. Then it will do the planning, self-correction, problem-solving, knowledge, representation, anything it will represent, perception, motion, manipulation, and the creativity. So it will give it thought. It will work on the base on motion, sensors. You have seen the sensors. Let's say, today the smart home, if I take an example, the smart home, how it work, when you enter the room, the whole light will be on, and as you leave the room, all the light will be closed. That is through the sensor. Okay, manipulation and creativity. Now machine itself can perform numerous tasks which otherwise require the human intelligence to accomplish. Now what it say, the machine do various tasks where the human intelligence is required to accomplish this. Now this machine, what we are talking AI, is not creating on its own. Some scientist or some developer is making the system to work in a such a way. It is for him, it is like a child which is making which is nurturing his child to think of himself or itself. Okay, as AI is a controversial topic, some would call it a blessing in a disguise for a business, while some it is a technology that can become harmful for humankind, as it is potentially capable of taking over and dominating the human being. Now it is one of the controversial topic. Many of the artificial intelligence movies have shown that. If you have seen the Terminator movie, where the AI is controlling the human. Okay, there are many movies. So it is why it is controversial, because people think once this computer, this system think on their own, they can control the human being. They will become much smarter than human being. Okay, and that will be a dangerous. But in the reality, the AI has affected our lifestyle either directly or indirectly and shaping the future of tomorrow. Now, what it say that the AI has many possibility, because if you see in the China restaurant or some of the restaurant, they are using the robotic arm for serving. Using the robotic arms, we people, the things are much faster. So it is just shaping the future much, much better way. Now, intelligence, if we talk, you become intelligent when you learn and solve the problem by yourself. When we can consider ourselves as intelligent, when we are looking a problem and when we are trying to solve it on our own. Suppose you touch a hot metal object, you will pull your hand away immediately. When this happened to you for the first time, the sequence of event and the result get stored in your brain. This is called an experience. Okay, let's say when you're doing the thing for the first time and you know whether it is a danger to your life or something, that will be stored in your mind when you do it for the first time. When you see a hot metal object next time, you will not touch it. You will just use the knowledge of your previous experience and decide not to repeat it again. Now, what it say, when you see the second time the same thing, you will not touch it. Why you will not touch it? Because you know while touching this you will get burned. So better not to touch it. This is considered as experience. The process of learning, comparing a previous experience and making a decision acting upon is the key of the human intelligence. Okay, so what we are doing, we are just learning, we are comparing this with the previous one, what we have experienced, and based on that we are acting on it. This everything is considered as human intelligence. You can make more and more complicated decision by learning from your past experience. And as we proceed, we are just learning from what we have done. You have seen updates in the app, and this is why the updates are coming. Whatever the past they have added, if it is not suitable for their user, they are just updating it, making more better. Okay. In the same way, when a computer or machine start thinking, using it experience for doing things correctly, you call it artificial intelligence. So when a computer or machine think on its own and try to experience it, understand it, it is considered as artificial intelligence. To make the intelligent machine, all you need is a memory or a space where the experience can be stored. You have played the chess. Okay, in the chess also the artificial intelligence is used, where the robot, that game chess robot, when you are playing against the computer, okay, they have stored all the moves, all the possible moves which can come, and it is also recording the new moves against the human. Okay, so what it say, it only just require the memory and space where the experience can be stored. Then you can use a method to apply this experience to new one and compare all this experience to come up with a logical conclusion, like holding the hot object with a glove on. Okay, so what it say, with this experience you will come up with something, some new ideas how to hold that hot object by putting a gloves. Okay, scientists and researchers are creating a new software program which try to recreate the process of human learning in a computer in an attempt to make them think and behave like a human. Now, scientists are creating new softwares so that they can enter the human brain in the robot. So the robot or the artificial intelligence think like a human. This program try to copy the functioning of the human brain. Hence, to the artificial intelligence, the robot can play, talk, and even guide us to do the thing in a better way. So what happened if we use this process, then artificial intelligence, that robot can play with us, can talk with us, even guide us. There are many robots, small robots. Let me show you one of the humanoid robot, that is Sophia. If you look for a term Sophia, She is the first humanoid robot. Okay. She has done many seminars. She is talking like a human. She is processing what you are asking. She will give the reply on its own. Okay. And there are such many robots are there. For India also, there is one robot called Lakshmi. Okay. Okay. Now our next topic is computational thinking. It's a set of problem solving method that involve expressing the problem and their solution in a way that the computer could execute. Now again, the computer, if it is becoming AI, it need to be taught. Okay. Unless you taught him, it will not learn. So we need to express the problem in such a way that the computer, that the AI system, the computer system could execute that way. Let's begin with the teaser. The trophy would not fit into the suitcase because it is too small. Pause for a moment to make sure that you understand it. Now trophy, okay, one trophy someone has owned would not fit into the suitcase because it is too small. Now it is so small that it cannot be entered, or it is too big that it cannot be entered. Now what was too small? Here what was too small? That is, suitcase was very small. Clearly it referred to the suitcase, not the trophy. Okay, again understand. What it said, the trophy is too small, would not fit into the suitcase. Why it is not fitting in the suitcase? Because suitcase is very small. How do you get the right answer? Observe that there is nothing in the sentence itself that give away the answer. To demonstrate it, let us change the last word from the small to big and nothing else. The trophy would not fit into the suitcase because it's too big. If the word changes, the meaning also changes. Now, it's too big because trophy is big, and it is too small because the suitcase is small. Now, what was too big? The trophy. Thinking is an internal mental process that uses the information as input and integrate the information with the previous learned material, resulting in the new knowledge. What it say? Thinking. The thinking part is a mental process. From the word it strike us small, that means here it is trying to say about the suitcase, because the trophy is very big that cannot be placed in the suitcase because of the suitcase size. Now, okay, so whatever the information we are getting, we are trying to process it, and based on that we are trying to get a new result. Computational thinking is yet another way of thinking which combine the previous mentioned ways of thinking. So what the computer do? It will check all its previous records, all its previous history, and based on that it assume ki what to do. Okay, it allows us to take a complex problem, understand what the problem is, and develop a possible solution. We can then present the solution in a way that a computer, a human or both can understand. Now what it say, computational thinking is another way of thinking which combine the previous mentioned way of thinking. It allows us to take a complex problem, understand what the problem is, and develop a possible solution. So that us and the computer both can understand. Now there are four techniques for doing this. One is decomposition, pattern recognition, abstraction, and algorithm. What is this decomposition? It will break the complex problem. If there is a complex means huge problem, it will break it into a small part. Now pattern. What are the pattern? If it is earlier also it happened something like that, that it will check. If there is any similarities among this. Abstraction, focus on the important information only and ignore the irrelevant details. Okay, if we see a movie, we only see the characters. We are not seeing the surrounding. When the characters are talking, we are seeing the characters. So it will look on the abstract part. Lastly, the algorithm, developing a step-by-step solution to the problem. So what it will do, it will create a step-by-step solution for the problem or rules to sort out. Okay, each technique is an important as the other. They are like legs on a table. If one leg is missing, the table will probably collapse. Correctly applying all the four techniques of the computational thinking will help in programming a computer. So what it say, all the four things are required. for solving a problem. If any one fails, the other solution will also fail. Now, what is an AI environment? Imagine you lost your wristwatch and you are searching for it in a bedroom. You work around the room and look at everything until you find the watch. Okay, it happened most of the time. We forget our thing from one place to another and we look around like madly. All this happened because from the day you are born, your eyes are sending signals to your brain. You have a tiny little cell in your brain called the neurons. The neurons take the signal as their food. You have seen so many watches in your life. That means you have a lot of neurons in your brain that knows what a watch look like and feel like. Okay, now sometimes what happens? Our brain is getting signal through the eyes. Okay, we know watch look like this. We have figured it out. Okay, our watches look like this, and we will look only that type of model. Is it? Sometimes it is in the front also. Then also we are missing. Okay, because we are not looking it that way. So what it say? Now if your father say go to the bedroom, I think I have seen your watch in the bedroom. You may have many group of neurons in your brain in which you know how your bedroom look like and how your watch look like. Okay, now what it say when your father tell you that your watch I have seen in the bedroom, the first thing that will come to your mind is your whole bedroom and the things in that bedroom. Okay, what are the possibility where you can keep that watch? So every neuron of that particle, or let's say all of that object, will be in your mind. Okay, you will never get confused between your bedroom and the fridge. This smart work take this neuron to do is referred to as intelligence. That neuron in your brain help you understand all those things and get happy when they do their job right and help you find your watch. Okay, now the neuron which is doing this will help you out to find your watch, and that will make you happy. Since you are tired of losing your thing all the time, what, why don't you teach a computer to find them for you? Okay, you can make the computer intelligent if they have a neurons like that, those in your brain. You could train a computer by giving it lot of neuron in the form of neuron network. You can provide the computers with the neurons using the neuron network technology. If a computer has a camera and a wheel to move around, for an example given over here, it could take a video of everything around it and give the video to its neuron. Okay, if that computer is having a video, or let's say camera in its body, it will take the picture of whole house. It will scan for every possibility, and based on that it will set up its mind. Okay, like finding your thing. They need to be happy while finding the right things and avoid the wrong things. So you can give the neuron a reward every time they find the right watch. Also, don't give them the reward if they find the wrong thing. Most importantly, you can teach them to find the right thing by giving a lot of examples. Okay, for that you have to train. Again, I told, when we are child, our parents are teaching us how to do the things, what is the right way. Same way for the scientist to train a robot, it has to do the work. Once it is trained, once it is understood, what the scientists do, it will copy all its data and it will fit in other robots. Now some of its component is, one is the machine learning, natural language processing, deep learning and neural network. Now what is the machine language? The machine learning is an application of artificial intelligence that provides the capability to computer to automatically learn and improve from the experience without being explicitly programmed. It focuses on the development of the computer program that can access the data and use it learned by themselves. Machine language is the language learned by the machine itself by experiencing the things, okay, so that it can program itself. AI is all about the data and the algorithm. Algorithm is a set of rules used to help the computer to perform decision-making operation. Let's consider one example. Let's say if you want to make Maggie, for an example, you will follow some steps. Same way the computer is also following some steps before doing something, and that step is considered, that rules is considered as algorithm, okay, which help the computer to learn. the accuracy of decision making capability is purely based on how accurately it has been trained and by using the authentic data. Okay, now it is all about training and the data we are feeding him. Generally, the more the data a machine language algorithm is provided, the more accurate it becomes. The more it will work, the more it will learn, the more it will become better. Some NLP, that is the natural language processing, is a very dynamic sector in an area of machine perception which is majorly associated with the automatic speech recognition. It is nothing but imparting the ability to understand the human language as it is spoken to the computer program. Now what is happening over here? So whatever the language, I tell you that the computer only understands 0 and 1. So whatever the language we are trying to speak with the computer, it will try to understand that and it will try to convert it to its own language. And again while replying, it will try to use the same computer language, but it will be in the English form. Okay. Now, deep learning is a subset of the machine learning. It's a function of the artificial intelligence that imitates the work of the human brain in processing the data and creating the patterns for making the decision. Now, deep learning is also a part of machine learning, and it's work like a human brain which processes the data and give the output. Deep learning programs are also able to make the decision by using the network of our brain cell called neurons. It using brain cell like neurons for communicating purposes. Now, neural networks are a set of algorithm modeled loosely after the human brain that are designed to recognize the pattern. Various patterns you can see. If you find any problem, let's say you fall, what is the first step you will do? If you fall, you will check for any scratch part or not. If you are having a scratch part, then you will go to the doctor for the tetanus, all that things. Okay. If the scratch came from any iron or from the dust, you will just go for the doctor. But if you fall in the home, you will just apply some water, you will clean it and all that process. So based on the problem pattern, the steps have been taken. Now, timeline of artificial intelligence, we will continue in our next class, next video. Okay, hope you understand this video.